Chloe? Oh, yeah, she's great. We're taking her in for a summer cut next week.
Don't do that. You'll ruin her coat, which she needs to keep her insulated from the heat.
Hey dudes, it's Whitney and Chloe here, and welcome back to the Doodle Dudes channel. Are you hearing conflicting information on whether or not a summer cut is essential for doodles? Many people say that doodles overheat and are very adamant that they should be cut short or even shaved for the summer. But others are also adamant that the coat insulates from both the cold and the heat and prevents sunburn. Confused yet? You are not the only one. In this video, we're going to discuss whether short summer cuts are safe for doodle coats, what length of hair makes the best happy medium for hot weather, and what lifestyle questions you should ask yourself when considering keeping your doodle long for the summer. Let's get into it.
Like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more doodle content.
So, there seems to be this common myth going around that doodles are double coated, that their coat insulates them from both the heat and the cold, and that shaving will most definitely ruin their coat forevermore. In case you don't know, a double coat is where a dog has two distinctive layers in their coat, and that would be the top coat and the undercoat. The undercoat is infamous for being the layer that sheds on most dogs, and it is excellent at trapping air, which helps insulate the dog. The top coat is the topmost layer of the coat, and it doesn't shed, but it does offer some extra protection for the dog. It is comprised of tougher guard hairs, which serve to protect the dog from sun rays and bug bites and basically everything external. Some dog breeds with a double coat include those with harsh or wiry coats, such as terriers, huskies, German shepherds, golden retrievers, and collies. So the primary reason why double-coated dogs should never be shaved is because their undercoat can actually grow back quicker than their top coat, and that could leave them looking a little bit wonky and patchy. And you know, they say that once you start to shave a dog with a double coat, you basically have to shave them their entire lives, and it really alters the structure and the integrity of the coat, and it loses its sole purpose, which is to insulate the dog and protect from the external things. Basically, shaving a double-coated dog strips him of the ability to protect himself for the rest of his life. So the big question is, does any of this actually apply to doodles? For the most part, no. The fact is that most vets, breeders, and groomers know that doodles do not have double coats. Actually, most doodles have a perceived single coat, which is a coat that combines the undercoat and the top coat with no real distinction between the two. Single-coated dogs are known for hardly shedding, which means that you basically have to cut the hair eventually because it'll just never stop growing. P.S. You can thank the poodle in your doodle for that. All of this is to say that doodles don't particularly have an insulating coat like true double-coated breeds. And unless you have a doodle with a high genetic makeup of a northern or harsh-coated breed, then you can really rest assured that shaving will do absolutely no harm to your doodle's coat. Now, groomers and vets will tell you that keeping at least half an inch of hair on the body will actually help protect them from sun and insulate them. However, your lifestyle choices should definitely determine whether or not your doodle gets shaved. The coat is indeed its own cooling system, but only if air can flow freely through the coat to the skin. This means that a matted dog cannot regulate his temperature, and we all know how prone to matting doodles are. In terms of lifestyle, you should ask yourself these three questions. Does your doodle swim a lot? Do you brush and comb on the regular? Do you really brush and comb on the regular? If your doodle likes to go swimming, he should definitely get a summer cut. This is because water contributes to matting and it can actually make mats tighter. Secondly, if you can keep up with the maintenance, then a summer cut is not required. In other words, you can keep him long if he is brushed regularly and has absolutely no mats. But is this a realistic scenario? As one groomer put it, the average owner doesn't have the time to maintain a coat like this. It just isn't reasonable for a family dog to require this much coat care. As a groomer, I can tell you that a dog in this coat would almost be a guaranteed shave down in no time flat after one trip to the lake or a few dips in a chlorinated pool. Not too many modern families have time to get home from a family outing, get unpacked, get the children fed, bathed, and to bed, and then deal with the dog's coat. In a perfect world, yes. In the real world, no. Basically, if you don't regularly brush your doodle, then he should definitely get a short summer cut. And this goes for all year round, not just during the summer. Now, aside from these few lifestyle questions, maybe you should also ask yourself if your doodle would simply prefer to have his hair cut. Plenty of doodle owners have noticed that their doodle becomes a completely different dog after he gets shaven. After all, most doodle owners agree that they tend to be very heat intolerant, which you can see here in this graph showing data from hundreds of doodle owners. For me personally, I know I've noticed a huge difference in Chloe's demeanor after she gets shaven. She definitely becomes more playful, energetic, and it almost seems like she's been liberated from her hair. Finally, if you do end up getting your doodle shaved for the summer, be sure to have him wear a t-shirt or some dog-safe sunblock so he can get some extra protection from the sun. So I hope that dispels the myth that doodles can't get shaved and answers any other questions you might have had on the subject. Let us know in the comments below if you get your doodle shaved or cut short for the summer, and if you've ever noticed a change in their mood after they've gotten their hair cut. Also, be sure to check out our awesome video tutorial on proper line brushing so you can help keep the mats and tangles at bay. I'll link to that in the description below. Whether you've been with us from the beginning or are brand new around here, thanks for sticking with us. Create a wonderful day, and don't forget to subscribe for more doodle content. Later, dudes! Thank you.